G'day! Today we're going to be taking a look at how we can make a mod for Space Engineers 2. Keen have been confident enough in this update that with only a few hours help from Mandydrews and Solipsist, which, fair bit of help, but with only that much that I should be able to make a mod and show it off in a short period of time. And it kind of works. I actually can, and I'm going to. So what we're going to do today is we're going to make a mod going all the way from Blender model through the mod tools, which is the ModHUB and VRageTools, and into the game and publishing it on the workshop, as well as taking an existing block and adding an additional function to it so that we can show off how that works as well. The block we're going to make today is something that kind of, well, I find a bit annoying that we can't do, but I totally understand why we can't do it. With these triangular pieces of catwalk, we cannot make armor that is perfectly flat to it because of the way that it occupies this little block here. So if we want to have these at the same level as our surrounding pieces of armor, we have to decide to either fill in this space with armor or make this a full square piece on the corner. But what if we could use the sort of solutions that are okay for mods, but aren't necessarily the best idea for a vanilla game? Such as, what if we made a block that is a combination of this detailing cube and this one? Except the triangular piece that we have at the end, that bit doesn't have any physics. It doesn't have a collision. So it can stick into the block space of our triangular piece of catwalk here and fill it in. So what we're going to do is we're going to make that and see how it looks. First off, we need to make the block, so jumping across to Blender. Before we get into the Blender stuff, if you're not familiar with Blender and you're not really interested in using Blender, I'll have the chapters listed in the description so you can jump ahead to the next part. But maybe there's some useful tips in here for if you decide to try and tweak some little models in the future. The first thing we're going to need to do in Blender is make sure that we've got the VRageTools plugin. So if we go to Edit, Preferences, and go to Add-ons, then Install from Disk, we can find our VRageTools zip file and click Install From. I'll make sure there's a link to this in the description, as well as Keen's written modding guides that are available. So with that installed, you'll see here VRageTools. Now we're able to export whatever we generate here in Blender into the correct formats for the mod SDK to understand. Now, I am not someone who is capable of tutorializing in Blender, as I do not really know how to do things in Blender all that much. But what I've done here is I have taken a block. I have created a bounding box that shows us the sort of space that this will take up. The reason that's important and the reason that having a 25 centimeter cubic bounding box is useful for making mods in Blender is that the game automatically generates mount points for blocks based on the model's geometry. So if the model is taking up this face by 50% or more, it will create a mounting point. So when I'm talking about a mounting point, I'm talking about when we have those green squares there as we move it around. Or for a block that's got a better example, the cockpit here. The mounting points for this cockpit are those green squares. Anywhere the model does not fully reach out to its limit will not get those mounting points. Anywhere that has 50% or more of the model reaching out to that edge will get a mounting point. The other things we can see in this scene, we've got our model itself, and then we've got an extra thing here, which is the collision. Because as I said before, we don't want the triangular part to have a collision, so our collision is a simple cube. And now we need to export the model and the collision from Blender in a way that VRageTools is going to be able to easily import them. To do that, we're going to go to our VRageTools here. We've got our model selected. And we're going to export this to our specified folder. The variant is non-fractured, and we're going to export LOD0. Okay. We've now exported the model. Now we need to export the collisions. At the moment, the collisions need to be exported up here rather than down here. Hopefully that'll be fixed soon. So we'll click Export Collisions. And now with those models exported, we can now move over to VRageTools, which means installing the mod SDK for Space Engineers 2. To get the mod SDK for Space Engineers 2, what we need to do is go to our library in Steam, go to Tools, and in Tools we can search for Space Engineers, and we see Space Engineers 2 Mod SDK. This is a somewhat sizable install, so keep that in mind if you're on Australian internet. But otherwise, once you've got it installed, we can launch it and start messing around with some stuff. When you launch it, you'll be met with this Mod Hub view. We can click Add Mod and call this Slope Fill Detailing, and then we click Start Editor. When you load up the editor, this is what you'll see. What we're going to do first is go to Window and check Asset Validation. So we have the Asset Validation window. This window is incredibly useful. This is where we see all the errors in our mod, and we can jump to the file that's specifically involved in that error. So we can find all the bits we need to fill in to ensure that this is going to work in the game. And so far, everything I've made that doesn't have an error at least loads into the game. So hopefully that continues to be true, as it's a much better thing to see them all the errors here rather than having Space Engineers crash when you make a bad mod. On the left over here, we can see our projects folder, but then beneath it, we can see two other folders. These are all the vanilla assets available, and there's a nice little lock symbol on them. That's because we could import from these, but we can't accidentally edit them. I cannot tell you how many times I have edited the main Space Engineers files when I was thinking I was editing my new copied SBC in SE1. So if you're anything like me, this is a big step in the right direction. Now in this view down here, we're going to right click, click Create Prefab, go to Blocks, go to Non-Breakable, because this is a detailing block, it doesn't need to have full breaking and all that fancy stuff done because it's quite small. And then we'll select Structural. This is going to create the basis of our detailing block. So we're going to call this the slope fill detailing block. Confirm. And now you can see that we have some errors up here in our asset validation. The next thing we're going to do is we're going to import our models. So we need to navigate to that folder in Explorer. And I've got my collision files, which are the bin and GLTF files. We need both of those. So we'll drag them across. Import. We also need to import this non-fractured folder. We'll import everything in that. I'll move my bin and GLTF into my non-fractured folder because this is where all my models are going to be kept. And we can see in here what we have now is the FBX, which is the file that we've generated from Blender. And then we have a .model file, which was generated by VRageTools on us importing this model. So the model file is where we're going to kind of combine the collision and the visual model into one thing. And this has one of our first errors that we're going to resolve. It is complaining that it does not have a default material. So we can pick one of the existing materials, or we can create our own, but we're going to pick one of the existing ones. So to pick one of the existing materials, we open the asset finder, which is the triple dots in a circle. And we're going to choose, because I think this is the one that looks the most like the default armor when we're using it, painted colorable metal. There we go, double click on that, error's gone. But down here you can see there is collision shape. At the moment it has none, but we want it to have our specific collision shape. So that's the slopefill.gltf file. We'll move that across, and that's now applied as the collision shape for our model. And for the rest of this, we're just going to follow through with the errors that are shown up here. We need a density, and we probably want this as mostly hollow since that's what the other detailing blocks are. Its fragility can remain as structural, then we'll go down here and we'll see recipe. We're going to create a new recipe for this. At the moment, I don't think the recipes are actually implemented in the game, but once we get survival mode, this might need to be something you fiddle around with. We're going to add a critical item, add an element, and we're going to choose, I don't know, construction components. That'll do. It's generic enough. We'll just have one of those. Nope, not 10. Not 11. One, thank you. And we'll go back. The next error is block kind. So we need to make the block groups for this for the G menu. So we can click plus. We're going to add a block kind. The block kind is going to be what we find it as in the G menu. So that's going to be slope fill. Description, slope, block, to fill, slope, space. Helpful. Then we can add this to a block group. So I'm going to add it to detailing, basic shapes. And then we'll see our last error, where we haven't actually applied the block model to the block. So the block model is the .model file here. We can drag that across. And now we should be good. We don't need a fractured model or a deformed model because we don't have those. And now, if we go and double click on this, it'll appear up in our render view, which means it might be ready to get into the game. Let's try it out, because we haven't got any errors. So we go to Project, Start Game. So if I go to the G menu and I search for Fill, I can't actually find my block. Similarly, if I go to Decor, it doesn't show up. However, because I added it to the Decor group, it has shown up in the scroll menu for the detail block. If I press R and jump through, it does show up here, which means there are a couple of problems we do need to fix. So we need to fix, one, that this isn't showing up where we want it to show up, but two, it's not lined up to the grid like we wanted it to be. As you can see, it is half a block out. What is working is that the, well, part of the triangle does not have collisions, as you can see there, but yeah, a few things to fix. So let's go back to VRageTools and see if we can fix that up. We know that we could find our block in our block group, but it wasn't showing up anywhere else. So let's try and redo that part and see if we can fix it. So we'll get rid of that. We'll click Add Element and we'll click Create Definition this time. And this time, let's go Slope Fill and we'll add a subcategory, which is going to be our detailing. There we go, detailing subcategory definition. Now, hopefully, because we've set this up a bit differently, it should show up in the menu differently. The second thing we need to fix is we need to offset the model. So at the moment, the model is half a detailing cube off. And I think it's going to be in the Z direction. So what we're going to do is go 0.125. And now, project, start game again. We see if it works. And you can keep iterating on things and changing things and loading the game up this way to see how things are progressing. All right, let's check out our G menu this time. And we have, ta-da! Structural block template 0.25 meters. I'll have to fix that. But this is our block. And there it is. And look at this. We can pop that out. And, it fits. It fills the space. We've got our little beveled edge. And it all kind of looks okay. Yeah, we've got this kind of staircase look at the edge here, which isn't ideal. There are things we could consider that might make this better. One of the things I would look at doing with this block is making it so that it actually takes up a full 2.5 meter size piece. And then it has the collision that is the step. And then it just fills in that gap so that instead of having all of these tiny little steps along it, we just have it at the big 2.5 meter cube size. But that's really cool. This is nearly ready to be published to the workshop. We just need to make sure that we've got an actual name for the block in the G menu, a thumbnail in the G menu, and maybe even a thumbnail for the mod. So let's go back to the VRage tools and add those in. To fix up the name, we need to click on this one here, which is the structural cube block definition partial definition, because it's inheriting some stuff from the detailing cube, so that's why it's a partial definition. So anything that changes with detailing cubes in the future that we haven't adjusted here will get inherited by this block, which may well improve the likelihood that this won't cause issues with later updates down the track. There we go, we've got that now. And then we need a thumbnail. For the thumbnail, we need a 200 by 200 pixel size image, as that's the size that Keen are using, so it's probably the best size to use. And I've made one previously, which we're going to use. It's fairly simple. Drag the PNG file in here. Bring this back up, and we can just drag the PNG file straight across to here. Now, one of the nice features of VRageTools is this little pin right here. If I pin that to the inspector, I can click on any of these other things. I can go into the folder, I can click on other stuff, and it will all stay here, which is kind of handy when you're navigating around trying to find stuff like your thumbnail to then drag across to there, and we now have a Gmenu thumbnail. And with that, let's check it one more time in game. Let's go to our Gmenu. And there we go. In our Gmenu, it's got the correct name and it's got the thumbnail. So now we can put that on the hotbar and it actually makes sense. Now it's a pretty ugly little thumbnail. I would definitely want to spend a bit more time making that match to Keen's style, but it works. It is functional for now. It does the trick. It gives us what we need so that we can see the block that we're using. So with that, we just need to add a thumbnail for the workshop and it's ready to publish. Back in the ModHUB, it's pretty easy to add a thumbnail. What we need to do is make sure that we have an image that is less than 1 megabyte in size because Steam, and then we just click on this little camera icon down here. Navigate to our folder. It's going to search for PNGs by default. I tend to make my workshop thumbnails JPEGs because I can make a higher resolution image and still have it 1 meg. So we've got our thumbnail here. I'll double click on that. Ta-da! It's a bit rough, but it'll work. And then we select some tags and we click publish to workshop. Yes. Publish. Mod published. Do you want to see it? Yes, I do. Ta-da! We have my first mod for Space Engineers 2 on the Steam Workshop, which is kind of cool. And now that we've published our mod to the workshop, let's see what else we can do. Let's go and add a new mod. Let's call this one Gyro Cockpit. Start editor. So for this one, let's start with an existing vanilla cockpit. So we'll go to assets, blocks, control seat, and we'll right click on control seat 250 partial def and say create partial copy. It'll start in our mods folder by default. So we can just click select folder and then select the assets folder. And now we have a copy of our control seat, which is our own copy. And only the settings that we change will be changed for our thing. But anything that gets changed with the cockpit in the future, like when it gets given a recipe for survival and all that sort of stuff, we will just inherit those changes every time. It's only going to change the stuff that we change, which is fan-freaking-tastic. So what we want to do is scroll down to the bottom of this and create add component. When you add a component to the component list here, what we're doing is adding an additional function to that block. And we're going to add the gyroscope function to a control seat. We're going to search for gyroscope, and then we're going to select gyroscope component. And this is expecting a definition, and we need to find, let's go gyroscope 250 definition. Okay, there we are. Now let's give this a name so that we can find it, which means we're going to go back to our control seat. And we're going to copy this file. So we're going to create partial copy. Selecting our assets folder, confirm. This is going to be gyro seat. That means we should be able to find it. So to make sure that this is going to show up in the G menu, we need to go to our block kind. If we select none, we can then click add. We're going to call this gyro seat. And as before, add an element here, add gyro seat. And then we want to find a category to put this under. And cockpits, there we go, that'll work. So now we should be able to go to project, start game. And this in theory should be working as both a gyroscope and a seat. There we go. We have our functional gyro seat. As you can see here, I am able to turn this seat that is nothing but a seat. Because it has the gyro function attached to it. So this is the sort of thing we can now do with SE2. We can add multiple functions to a block, and you can have all sorts of crazy things combined, which is going to create some really cool opportunities for mods. I am so looking forward to the crazy things that people manage to make with this and seeing what comes of it, because so much more is possible here in SE2 than we've ever experienced before. I have to say a massive thank you to Drui for organizing this, but to Mandydrews and to Solipsist for actually teaching me this stuff. It is really cool. And believe me, there are some functions people are going to find already in the game that are going to make some wild mods in the coming weeks. It's going to be amazing. Keen are going to be doing their live stream thing on Monday so that we'll all have access to it then. So there's all that and plenty more to come. And I will see you then.